Hi, Sarah from the Upcoming. So lovely to speak with you. So this is an incredible role. Looks like you had a lot of fun. What drew you to the project?
Well, first of all, Tom Harper, because I love him and had worked on War and Peace with him, and he brought the script to me, and I was like, sure, before I even read it, because if he told me to lie down on a train track, I probably would do it. And then I read the script, and I was like, this is an incredibly human, raw woman who has the bravery to run for her dreams, despite everybody else saying that she isn't deserving to have a dream. And she has, you know, she's got foibles and vulnerabilities. Sorry, my friends are pulling faces on me. That's Stephen Kearney, our second AD. Never employ him ever again. Sorry.
Okay, and can you just tell me how you prepared for the role?
I first started with the music, so I like came over and I was filming something else at the time, and I was kind of coming back and forth to London working with amazing musicians like Neil McCall and Chris Vatilario and Ben Nichols and Stuart Nesbitt, and we started from that, and then just weeks beforehand worked on the dialect, and then between Tom and George Steele, our DOP, and Nicole and Faye, we just all were in a big old pot of mixing ideas together. God, to even be part of this festival, be part of the BFI and be part of the filmmaking, I still can't quite believe how lucky I am. Like, I always dreamed to be part of this family, and I think we all should be proud of each other, you know. It's not a competition, it's about telling stories to people to let them dream as well about what they want to do. So yeah, good on all of us. I generally choose things on character. Like, this was a gift. To be honest, I thought country music was a pick, and I had absolutely no relationship with it whatsoever. I had done like a bit of blues and jazz, but like, then I was opened up to the kind of storytelling in country music and the direct honesty of the lyrics and the simplicity about the human heart. And so that was a gift. But really, it's always based on character, who's doing it, and if I'm going to have fun. That was maybe the best day of my life, to sing with Chris Christopherson. And also, and we did it in character, so it was like, I had no idea what was going to happen, because you can't even rehearse for something like that, and it was like the most beautiful sunny day. I was singing in Hampstead Heath with my folks around me, my band, who are the most incredible musicians. I don't know, I don't generally plan anything. It has been such a like lovely thing to have music come back in my life, and I hadn't really sung for ages before I did this film, really since I went to college, and I kind of was a bit nervous of it, and so to be able to have it back in my life and get to work with the most amazing musicians, listen to the most incredible music and stories in music has been a complete and utter joy. It's so hard to do anything after this.